south, a gracious land where dwell a gracious people. American history was. Here are the statues and monuments raised to the hardy pioneers who sought freedom and found it here in. These are the honored halls in which that freedom was proclaimed to the world. Against this background, names were made great, illuminating the pages of our great historical traditions. Princess Pocahontas, Captain John Smith, General George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, and others revered in hallowed memory. This is the South of romantic legend, whose beginnings were the beginnings of America itself, where almost 350 years ago, the first colonists came to live and build for the future that is our proud heritage today. Way down south in the land of cotton, in song and story, in the strong light of living reality, for years that stretch back through bygone generations, the world has looked to the Southland for a picture of life peculiar to that region, the calm, unhurried way of good living. The charm of southern cities, the peace and quiet of the southern countryside, of southern towns and villages, of heroes, of women of melting beauty. All these and more, from time out of mind, have been the heart and soul of the great American Southland. That was the old South of yesteryear. But today, there is something else. A new spirit that gives pace and tempo to modern living. A new mode of existence, born of the spirit of progress, has arisen on the foundations of the South of song and story. The tempo of life is quickened. In step with the times is the keynote of the day. And so this story emerges. The story of a new South, whose roots are embedded deep in the honored traditions of the old, building always for the greater Southland in industry, in agriculture, in science, in education, great universities dedicated to higher learning, fine institutions for the teaching of the arts and sciences of modern times. Speaking proudly of this great region, a southern poet has said, "There is a power here that grips the mind. That power is deep in the rocks and in the mountains. That power is in the fruit of the good earth, giving life and sustenance to us and to those with whom we share our bounty. That power is in the spirit that fires our hope and lights our way to even better today and tomorrow." The wealth of a nation, or any part of that nation, is measured by its natural resources, its industry, its distribution facility, its people. This southeast corner of our nation is blessed more than most with the riches of a fertile soil and mild climate, untold wealth in minerals and forests,